Yo, what's up Team RTT? How you all doing? Hope you guys are doing good and wonderful. Welcome back to another video. So in today's video guys, you know, I'm going to share with you guys how to become a profitable trader. And this is an advice for me to new upcoming traders or even intermediate forex traders in order for you to be profitable like us, yeah? But don't expect to be able to become profitable, you know, in 1 month, 2 months, 3 months, and you expect, you know, to just make money like the way we do, or to, you know, see a lot of things like the way we see, right? Because we have been trading, or me personally, I've been trading since 2017, but I wasn't actually profitable. But I got profitable in 2019, so 2017 to 2019, it was not actually profitable for me. But if you watch this video to the end, definitely you should be able to now become a profitable trader, or you should be able to improve your trading skills in order for you to become a profitable trader, because all of us want to be profitable and want to make a lot of money in the forex market, right? That's the end goal why we are here in the first place. So I'm going to share with you 3, 4, 5 advice that you need as a new forex trader so that you can become a profitable trader. So make sure you watch this video to the end. And of course, if today is your first time here, you don't know me, right? I'm Israeli trader and I'm a forex trader. So make sure you give this video a thumbs up and subscribe to the channel. Most importantly, share with your friends and family. And don't forget to follow me on Instagram, Twitter, and of course our Telegram channel. So with that being said, guys, let's dive into, you know, advice that I have for you guys to become a profitable trader. Okay guys, so the first advice I have for you guys is risk management. Definitely, risk management is what number one, because without risk management guys, definitely you end up blowing a lot of your account. So what do I mean by risk management is, let's say for example you have a $100 account, not $100,000, yeah? You have a $100 account and you want to, you know, make $1,000, or you want to make $10,000 without $100, that's an unrealistic approach. Like, you'll find it very difficult if you follow normal risk management. You'll find it very difficult for you to turn that your $100 to $10,000. So you might end up just over leveraging on that account and blow the account completely, and from there you might start up from scratch again. So that's not advisable to do. You know, instead, if you are actually coming into the forex industry now as a new or intermediate forex trader and all you have is $100, if it's me personally, yeah, I would advise you to just go and make some research about proprietary firm trading or prop firm trading and use that $100 to just buy, you know, account with any other prop firm. But me personally, I use my funded effects. I love my funded effects when it comes to prop firm, yeah? That's what I use. So, you know, just buy prop firm with that $100 and stop risking it, or stop trying to make $10,000 with that $100, because you might end up putting like one standard lot size, two lot size, three lot size, five lot size, you know, as much as you can, so that you can just make quick money, you know, to just flip that your account, which is that $100 account, right? So if you are trying to apply a proper risk management in order for you to manage that $100 account, definitely you might end up doing, you know, 1 year without even reaching $200, that 100% gain, yeah? So I would advise you to just maybe buy profit with that $100 and stop trying to over leverage and go full margin so that you can just make a lot of money with that $100, yeah? So, you know, in order for you to perform a good risk management, you need to just be risking like 0.5%. That's what I do personally on my account. I risk 0.5%, 1%, and at maximum of 2%. No matter how I have strong belief in my analysis, I will not go above 2%, yeah? So 2% is actually my max target on my funded account or on my personal account. So make sure you just set that as rule for yourself as a criteria that you have to check before entering any particular trade. So, you know, lower down your risk on each account you are trading. So that's the first advice I have for you guys when it comes to, you know, risk management. Okay guys, so the second advice I have for you guys to become a profitable trader, if you are just coming into the forex industry, is always do your analysis. This is very, very common, or let me say this is very common mistake that some new forex traders make. They just come in and, you know, without doing analysis, they feel, you know, they can just enter a trade and start trading just like that. That cannot work, guys. So if you don't do your analysis before you execute your trade, definitely, please, I beg of you to start doing your analysis from today in order for you to become a profitable trader. So maybe if you don't have time, actually, on weekends, Saturday and Sundays, you can actually do your analysis. If you are trading currency pairs like GBPUSD, EURUSD, AUDUSD, GBPJPY, EURJPY, USDJPY, and so on and so forth, definitely just take out your time, 1 hour, 2 hours, make sure you do your analysis. Fundamental analysis, sentimental analysis, and of course your technical analysis. These three types of analysis, you have to do them every weekend in order for you to just familiarize yourself with what the market is going to do during the week, or what are you going to be expecting, or what you are going to be expecting for the whole week, starting from Monday to Friday, you know, to just give you an idea of what the market is going to do. So it's very, very important for you to actually do your analysis on Saturdays and Sundays. And of course, before you execute your trade, just cross-check it and confirm that, you know, what you are about to enter, be it buy or sell on a particular pair, correspond with whatever you are expecting according to your analysis. Yeah, so don't just go in blindly and start think that you just, you know, buy and the market will be buying. Nah, that's not how it works, guys. So you have to do your proper analysis in order for you to become a profitable trader and, you know, make a lot of money in the forex market. So that's the second advice I have for you guys in order for you to become a profitable trader. Okay, so with that being said, we've actually heard the first one and the second one. So the third one I have for you guys is, don't let FOMO, fear of missing out, overrule your decision. So what do I mean by that? That sounds complex, yeah? So what I mean is, if you are done with your analysis and the analysis says you have to still wait before executing that particular trade, definitely just wait. But fear of missing out will not allow you to wait in order for you to execute that particular trade later on. But, you know, you'll be scared of like missing some particular pips in the market. Meanwhile, your analysis is telling you that, yo, you have to wait maybe for this candle to close. Or if you are doing an analysis on 1 hour time frame, definitely you have to wait for that 1 hour candle to close before you now know that this candle is a valid candlestick pattern before you execute the trade. But fear of missing out will not allow you to do that. Instead, you just enter the trade, and that's where drawdown will now surface. And from there, you might end up closing that trade in negative, or you might end up adding more. So that's not actually good for you. That's not a good practice for you. That's not a good practice, guys. So don't let FOMO overrule your decision. So with that being said, guys, thank you very much for watching. I will see you guys in our next video. And just a quick reminder, if today is your first time here and you did not subscribe to the channel, please, guys, subscribe to the channel, share the video with your friends and family in order for them to just, you know, learn one or two things from this or from me, so that you can become a profitable trader like us. So with that being said, thank you very much for watching. I will see you guys in our next video. Peace out, guys.